Let's start. This is the formula for distance, finding the distance between two points, x1, y1 and x2, y2. It can be square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square, or x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square also, because the difference is being squared, either x1 and x2, even if they change the positions, we will not have any problem. Now, here, distance between the origin and point, any point P, xy, will be given by x square plus y square under square root. Okay, these are the things we learned in the previous exercise. Now, this is an exercise on section formula. Section formula also we explained that time in the previous classes. Now, the coordinates of P, xy, which divides the line segment joining A, x1, y1, and B, x2, y2 internally in the ratio m1 is to m2 are m1 x2 plus m2 x1 by m1 plus m2, comma m1 y2 plus m2 y1 by m1 plus m2. If the ratio is k is to 1, then the coordinates of P will be given by k x2 plus x1 by k plus 1, comma k y2 plus y1 by k plus 1. Typically, sometimes the ratio may be 1 is to 1. In that case, we say the point that divides the line segment is called the midpoint. Then the ratio, the coordinates of that point are given by x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. That means this is the formula for midpoint of line segment joining P x1 by 1 and Q x2 y. Okay, now quickly we'll go through each question. Those who did not listen so far in the previous classes, understand them. Otherwise, take a click if necessary or write down quickly. Here we are going to find the coordinates of point P, which divides line segment AB joining minus 1, 7 and 4, minus 3 in the ratio 2 is to 3. 2 is to 3. Then m1 is to m2 is 2 is to 3 and x1 y1 are minus 1, 7, x2 y2 are 4 and minus 3. So from m1 we start 2 into 4 plus 3 into minus 1. So we go to the right first, then come to right. Like this we go in a circular way, anti-clockwise. You can say anti-clockwise circle we make. Then for y coordinates also are the same way. 2 into minus 3 plus 3 into 7. That is 2 fours are 8. 2 fours are 8 plus minus 3. That is 8 minus 3 by 5. Minus 6 plus 21 by 5. Meaning we have 5 by 5 and 15 by 5, that is 1 is to 1 and 3. These are the coordinates of point P, x1, y1. Sorry, P, xy we can say, which divides the line segment given in the ratio 2 is to 3. Right. Now, here we go. Second question. Find the coordinates of the points of trisection. Points of trisection of the line segment joining 4, minus 1 and minus 2, minus 3. See, question 2 is like this. Trisect means making something into 3 equal parts. To make something into 2 equal parts, we need 1 point. To make something into 3 equal parts, we need 2 points. Those 2 points, let the points be P and Q, and the coordinates are x1, y1, x2, y2. When P is the point here, then if P is the point here, which is dividing the line segment, A, P, P, Q, Q, B, will be of equal length. So this line segment, this line segment, this line segment, all the three, four, all the three parts are equal. That means if this is one unit, from here to here it will be two units. That means P divides AB in the ratio 1:2, Q divides AB in the ratio 2:1. This is what we have to understand. Now, two points we'll find here. It's a nice 3 marks question. All of you be alert in doing it. Section 5. One, that is 1:2, no, therefore 1 × -2, and we go this side, and 2 × 4 here, 2 × 4, 8, 1 × -2 − 2/3, so it is 6/3, 2. We have got the x coordinate. Y coordinate also same, 1 × -3 + 2 × -1 here, that is −3 − 2 − 5/3. So 2 − 5/3 are the points here. Now the second one, Qx2y2 are given like this. 2 × 2, because 2:1 is the ratio here in which Q is dividing the line segment. Therefore, it is 2 × −2 + 1 × 4. That is −4 + 4 = 0/3, 0. X coordinate is over. Y coordinate, 2 × −3 here, 2 × −3 plus 1 × −1 / 2 + 1. That is −6 − 1/3. That is −7/3. So 0 − 7/3 is the other point. This is how we obtain the points of trisection of a line segment joining the, if you know the coordinates of the end points here. Now we shall move on to let point P −1, 6 divides the line segment joining −3, 10, 6, −8 in the ratio k:1. Here the point is given, we have to find the ratio like this. Point is very clearly given, P −1, 6. AB, the end points of the line segment are given. Then we need to find the ratio in which it divides the line segment. Now let us see the formula, k:1 formula we use here. So kx2 + x1 / k + 1, ky2 + y1 / k + 1 is the formula for finding the point P. P −1, 6 equal to this. Therefore, k × −6 + 1 × −3 / k + 1. That is the x coordinate. And y coordinate is k × −8 + 1 × 10 = 10 / k + 1. So here, −1, 6 is equated to 6 × k. That is k, it is 6k − 3 / k + 1. −8k + 10 / k + 1. Now, if two points are equal, their coordinates are equal. X coordinates are equal, y coordinates are equal. Therefore, I am equating the x coordinates here. Then what will happen? −6k − 3 / k + 1 = −1. Meaning 6k − 3 = −1 × k + 1. 6k − 3 = −k − 1. That is 6k + k. I am bringing this k this side. Then it is 6k + k = of course 3 this side now. When it is 3 is this side now, −1 + 3, meaning 7k = 2. The k = 2/7. Therefore the ratio is k:1. Ratio is k:1, meaning 2/7 = 1. To make it a whole number ratio, we'll multiply by 7, the denominator here. So it will be 2:7. Okay, this is the entire problem. Hope you all understood this one. Shall I move on to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is the question, next one. Find the ratio in which the line segment joining 1 − 5 − 4 − 5 divided by the x-axis, and also find the coordinates of the point of division. Very nice question. Sometimes it may be asked for 3 marks. Sometimes for 2 marks. See, I will divide this question into two parts. First slide, first part. Second slide, second part. So immediately you have to note down the question as well as the steps here. First step, we are drawing the picture for this one. The entire picture will be going like this. A, B. Point A is here. B is there in the second quadrant. And A is in the fourth quadrant. And the points are given here like this. And point P is on the x-axis here. It is dividing AB. Let it be the ratio K is to 1. Let the ratio be K is to 1. Then point P is on the x-axis. So its x-coordinate will be existing. Y-coordinate is 0. So x0 are the coordinates of point P, which divides the line segment AB in the ratio K is to 1. Now, this is the second part of the question. Already we checked it, of course. Now, point P x0 is equal to kx2 plus x1 by k plus 1, ky2 plus y1 by k plus 1. K into minus 4 plus 1 by k plus 1, k into minus 5 by k plus 1. Now, this is, here if you equate the x-coordinates, of course, we can express the value of k in terms of x or x in terms of k, that's all. Nothing would happen. Therefore, firstly, we will equate the y-coordinates, the yellow-colored, that means highlighted coordinates we will equate. So, 5k into 5 means 5k minus 5 by k plus 1 is 0. When I cross-multiply, 5k minus 5 is 0 into k plus 1 or 0. So, 5k is equal to 5 or k equal to 1. The ratio is now k is to 1 is 1 is to 1. Now, we can very well equate the x-coordinates and write the value of k in the equation and obtain the value of x there. Minus 4k plus 1 by k plus 1 is equal to x now. Minus 4 and k is 1 here, therefore minus 4 into 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 is equal to x. This is minus 4 plus 1 minus 3 by 2, it is x. So minus 1.5. Therefore, the point is minus 1.50 and the ratio is 1 is to 1. These are the answers for the question here. Okay? Any doubt about this one? If 1, 2, 4, y, 1, x, 6, 3, 5 are the vertices of a parallelogram taken in order, find the values of x and y. Let us draw a figure for this one because they are the vertices of a parallelogram. I am drawing a parallelogram and assigning points, the coordinates to the points A, B, 1, 2 and 4, y, B, C, x, 6, D, 3, 5. So, in a parallelogram, the diagonals bisect each other. That means midpoint of one diagonal is equal to the midpoint of other diagonal. Diagonals bisect each other. So midpoint of diagonal AC is equal to midpoint of diagonal BD. Midpoint formula we have put now x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2. Midpoint is nothing but a point that divides a line segment in the ratio 1 is to 1. The ratio 1 is to 1. Now, AC, midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. Midpoint of AC is equal to 1 plus x by 2, comma 2 plus 6 by 2. That is, again here, 4 plus 3 by 2, comma y plus 5 by 2. Now, equate the x coordinates and the y coordinates. X, and in all these, 2 is the denominator, so you avoid the denominator, no problem at all. Now, 1 plus x equal to 4 plus 3, that is 7. 1 plus x equal to 7 is one equation. 2 plus 6 equal to y plus 5, or y plus 5. Now, A, x, y, A, and B, 1, 4, C is 2 minus 3, let us think. In that case, now, 2 minus 3 is equal to Remember, for a diameter, see, center is the midpoint. Center is the midpoint because 2 times of radius is the diameter. Radius is nothing but distance between the center and any point. Therefore, AC is the radius, BC is the radius. So, therefore, C is the center of the diameter. So, that is nothing but the midpoint. So, midpoint formula we use here to find the center, thinking the coordinates of X and Y, are assuming the coordinates of X and Y as X and Y. Sorry, coordinates of A as X and Y. Now, 2 minus 3, X plus 1 by 2, comma Y plus 4 by 2 are equal to 2 minus 3. Here, X plus 1 by 2 is equal to 2, meaning X plus 1 is 2, 2s are 4, X equal to 4 minus 1, 3. Here, Y plus 4 by 2 is equal to minus 3, meaning Y plus 4 is equal to minus 6, 2 into 3, minus 6. Y plus 4 is minus 6, so Y equal to minus 6, minus 4, minus 10. So, coordinates of A are 3, minus 10. This way we can solve this problem. Now, question, if A and B are minus 2, 2, 2, minus 4 respectively, find the coordinates of P such that AP equal to 3 by 7 AB. Very important question for 3 marks. Okay, this is the way we have the points AB and P. P, A, 3 by 7 of AB, meaning 7 times of, you can say, 3 parts are here AP, and here this is 3 parts, this is 7 parts. AP by AB, you can write here, AP by AB is equal to AP by AB, which is equal to 3 by 7, meaning if AP is 3 times of some 3 units and this is 7 units, the entire length of line segment AB is 7 units, this is 3 units, meaning the remaining part is 4 units, no? Remaining part is 4 units. So therefore, we can say point P is dividing the line. Of course, how to divide this one I wrote, but all this is not required. AB by AP is 7 by 3. Of course, you can write this one. After this, directly you write this. Okay? Enough. And all this can be avoided. No problem. Not required. But how did we get? This is the way you got it. Okay? This is AP is to PB is 3 is to 4. Meaning formula to find the coordinates of P. Okay? Now, what are the coordinates of point P here? 3 into 2, 3 into 2 plus 4 into minus 2 by 3. 3 into 3 plus 4, again 3 into minus 4 plus 4 into minus 2 by 3 plus 4. Find the coordinates of points which divide the line segment joining A minus 2, 2 and B 2, 8 into 4 equal parts. Earlier we have seen a case of 3 equal parts trisection. Here this is quadrisection, you can say 4 equal parts. So there should be 3 points which divide the line segment into 4 equal parts. Say the points be P1, P2 and P3. P1, P2, P3. Then these points P1, P2, P3 are dividing the line segment AB into 4 equal parts. That means AP1 is equal to P1, P2 is equal to P2, P3 is equal to P3B. Now here we'll apply a logic here. What is the logic? But if you say all the four parts are equal, towards P2 on the left hand side for P2, P2 is the midpoint of AB, I say. Do you agree or not? P2 is the midpoint of AB. Therefore, the midpoint can be found easily using the formula, midpoint formula, minus 2 plus 2 by 2, comma 2 plus 8 by 2. That is 0 by 2, 10 by 2, 0, 5. So 0, 5 is coming here. P2 P2 is found now. Once P2 is found, you can understand another here. AP1 is equal to P1 P2. That means P1 is the midpoint of AP2. A for line segment AP2, P1 is the midpoint. Therefore, you for these two points midpoint, we are finding as 2 - 2 + 0/2, 2 + 5/2, that is -2/2 - 1, 7/2. Next, for this one, P3 and 5 + 8/2, and 5 + 8 is 13/2. So P1, P2, P3 are found like this. Clear? Any doubt? Very simple, of course. Very simple. Okay, we can use midpoint formula to find all the three points very easily, automatically. Shall I move on to the next one? Here is the next. Find the area of the rhombus. From 8th class itself, we know in 8th class we learned this. Area of a rhombus is half product of diagonal. Now, here if you find the length of diagonals, find the product of it, you get the area. Formula. Length of diagonal AC is equal to x1 - x2, 3 - -1² + 0 - 4². This is 4² 6 of 16 under square root. Under square root, you are getting 2 times of 16, meaning for 16, 4 is the square root. So 4√2 is the answer here. So this, of course, is not required for you. Next one. Length of BD, same way, 4 - -2² + 5, find the area. Area equal to half product of lengths of diagonals, half AC into BD. So half of 4√2 × 6√2, √2 × √2 will be 2 only, this is 2. So this is equal to half into 4 × 6 × 2. √2 × √2 is 2. And 4 × 6 = 24 square units is the answer. Did you all understand this?
Yes, sir.